The original National Wrestling Federation was a wrestling promotion based in Buffalo, New York, and owned and operated by promoter Pedro Martinez. It ran from 1970 to 1974. The promotion was then revived in 1986 by Robert Raskin. The revived promotion closed in 1994. Pedro Martinez owned the original National Wrestling Federation, which operated from 1970 to 1974. The NWF Heavyweight Championship was created by Pedro Martinez and co-founded by Johnny Powers for the NWF promotion in New York in 1970 against the NWA, but it recognized the world champion. The title was mainly defended in the New York, Eastern Canada area until then-champion Johnny Powers took the belt with him on a tour of Japan with Tokyo Pro Wrestling. Powers would eventually lose the title to Antonio Inoki, who would take the belt with him when he founded New Japan Pro Wrestling. Some of the talent appearing on the NWF shows from 1970 to 1974 included Johnny Powers, Superfly Jimmy Snuka, Bobo Brazil, Ernie Ladd, Abdullah the Butcher, Dusty Rhodes, Dick Murdoch, Johnny Valentine, Wahoo McDaniels, Tiger Jeet Singh, Haystacks Calhoun, The Rougeaus, Crazy Luke Graham, Stan the Man Stasiak, and Dominic DiNucci. The NWF North American Heavyweight Championship was a secondary singles title in the promotion. The title started in 1968 as a National Wrestling Alliance title named the NWA North American Heavyweight Championship Buffalo Cleveland version until the NWF was founded in 1970. The NWF would close in 1974 and the title migrated to New Japan Pro Wrestling. The title was then abandoned in 1981. As mentioned, Johnny Powers co-founded the National Wrestling Federation. He was the NWF World Heavyweight Champion and was the star of Championship Wrestling with Johnny Powers. He was the only wrestler then and to since have a television show named after him, other than Hulk Hogan's Rockin' Wrestling. He was NWF North American Champion 7 times and NWF World Champion 3 times. In an interesting side note, Powers wrestled Bruno Sammartino on 6 different occasions for the Worldwide Wrestling Federation title in the mid-60s. He also wrestled NWA champion Lou Thesz, Gene Kaniski, and AWA champ Vern Gagne. In 1973, Powers sold the NWF to Antonio Inoki and New Japan Pro Wrestling. Powers was defeated by Antonio Inoki for the NWF World Heavyweight Championship December 10, 1973 in Tokyo. The NWF Heavyweight Championship and the NWF North American Heavyweight Championship were later used by New Japan Pro Wrestling as its main titles until 1981. Inoki became the wrestler most associated with the titles due to his high-profile defenses, defeating the likes of Stan Hansen, Andre the Giant, Tiger Jeet Singh, and Ernie Ladd. Recognized as a 4-time NWF Heavyweight Champion between the years of 1973 and 1983, Inoki was champion for all but 6 months. Inoki's fourth reign was actually due to the decision to hold up the championship, following a defense against Stan Hansen on April 17, 1981, that ended in no contest. Inoki later regained the title on April 23, 1981 by defeating Hansen in a rematch. He retired the NWF title immediately after the match due to his desire to enter the International Wrestling Grand Prix League. The NWF Heavyweight Championship and the NWF North American Heavyweight Championship was used by New Japan Pro Wrestling as its main titles until 1981. In 1986, former basketball coach Robert Raskin purchased the Allentown, Pennsylvania-based Continental Wrestling Alliance from DC Drake and named it the National Wrestling Federation. Raskin changed the name of the CWA to the National Wrestling Federation in 1986. and he spared no expense in bringing top talent that had previously worked for the WWF or NWA. Names such as Sergeant Slaughter, Jimmy Snuka, the Wild Samoans, Bruiser Brody, the Honky Tonk Man, Jewel Strongbow, Wendy Richter, Ivan Koloff, Rocky Johnson, Nikolai Volkoff, the Tonga Kid, Abdullah the Butcher, Dr. D. David Schultz, Colonel DePiers, Tom Brandy, David Sammartino, and even Stan Hansen. The organization revived the NWF Heavyweight Championship and also created an NWF Women's Championship. Under the direction of Raskin, the National Wrestling Federation grew rapidly. Using wrestlers who were formerly under contract with the World Wrestling Federation and the National Wrestling Alliance, Raskin spared no expense in making the product a watchable alternative to the wrestling shows which were currently on television. Drake, who was the champion, also headed up the booking and television production ends of the business. DC Drake won a tournament to crown the first NWF Heavyweight Championship in 1986. At this point in time, DC Drake would begin using a hardcore style inside the ring and spill buckets of blood in matches with Jewel Strongbow, among others. Although nothing new, Drake sparked a hardcore take on the entire federation, including many specialty matches such as Indian strap matches, dog collar matches, steel cage matches, and one of the first women's steel cage matches featuring Wendy Richter and Heidi Lee Morgan. Raskin felt that the NWF should move the television tapings from the Eastern Pennsylvania Hall to various locations around the East Coast. Matches were taped at arenas in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, New York, and other locations. Raskin also hired a young Paul Heyman to handle color commentary on the TV show. Paul Heyman was hired by the promotion as the on-air announcer. One of Paul's first official runs in the business took place in NWF. Some of the tag teams involved in the NWF included the Nasty Boys, the Wild Samoans, Buddy Rose and Doug Summers, the Fantastics, and the Midnight Rockers. Drake and Raskin also decided to put more emphasis on the NWF Women's Division. As the Women's Division became established, Wendy Richter was defeated in a questionable fashion in Madison Square Garden by the Fabulous Moolah and left the World Wrestling Federation. She entered the NWF and quickly captured the title from Heidi Lee Morgan. Raskin, seeing the organization expanding, merged with Creative Entertainment, a sports and entertainment promotional organization from Philadelphia. The move proved to be a smart one, as Creative Entertainment was able to book matches for the NWF all across the country. The television show expanded to sports channels and broadcast stations across the country and appeared in foreign markets in Europe, South and Central America, and even Asia. As the company grew, creative differences began to split the organization, and several in the front office left to pursue other ventures. As the capital investment stopped, the television product was halted. The promotion closed in 1994. Many consider the NWF to be an inspirational precursor to Tri-State Wrestling and ECW. That's the untold story of the National Wrestling Federation.